been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night. I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I'll find the things that you do will make me feel alright.
When I'm home, everything seems a bit right. When I'm home, feeling you holding me tight, tight, yeah.
It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night. I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I'll find the things that you do will make me feel alright. You know I feel alright. You know I feel alright.
There's a battle battle in the marketplace. Mommy is a singer in a band. Dennis returns to Molly, girl, I like your face. And Molly says that she thinks about him. Oh, la dee, oh, la la, la goes on. La la la, la la goes on. Oh, la dee, oh, la la, la goes on. La la la, la goes on. Move it on, go, boy. Take over, keep on down.
Hello, everybody worldwide. Welcome back to Ham Radio Live. Good to have you guys. Monday, February 13th, 2023. We're getting a little fun with the Beatles to start us out. Great mix. Listen. Back, and the Marama is heading back shortly. Wherever you may be around the world, want to say welcome to you and a big away we go. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to the chat. Very happy Monday to you around the world, wherever you may be. It's good to see you. I wasn't planning to come today. I'm grateful that I did. It gives me a chance to see all you guys. My brother starts radiation treatment tomorrow, and it's every weekday for the next 3 weeks. So we're going to do our best. It's about 130 miles round trip, which is going to be a whole bunch of fun, I'm sure. Welcome to the show, guys. Good to see you guys. I got everything kind of mixed up because it's all for the shortwave show. See what I mean? Listen carefully here.
I love that.
Yeah. Station Rock!
The greatest hits on Earth. Classic hits. Over the Horizon Radio. Yeah.
Allow me to introduce myself.
Everything's like
my
that.
My name is Wile E. Coyote. Genius.
So let's find big applause. Okay, there we did. We got it. Big applause is here. Thank you for coming. Big applause. And now Larry.
And now, Hilary Moment.
You know, it's been crazy to do this show lately, and I'm grateful you guys are here. Thank you for coming. This is truly a treat. If you'd like to get an amateur radio, we'll start there. The American Radio Relay League can help you find a local to you amateur radio club, which is really good. They'll help you get started and get you licensed too. www.arrl.org. hit the country desk bar. Let them know where you live and that you want your license. They'll send you an email back with a local to you amateur radio club, and that club will help get you on amateur radio. Get a hold of me in the email at info@hamradiolive.org. And today's topic question, in case you have not heard the news yet, how do you feel about the early end of 3Y0J, the DXPedition of Bouvet Island? This news just broke today, and it was a surprise to, I think, many people. Steve Haas, who is the administrator of the 3Y0J Facebook page, and you know, does their media work as well. 3Y0J will QRT Tuesday, February 14, 2023, at 3 UTC. So they're now QRT. And that's it. They're going to then pull out, transport all the equipment back to the ship, which is named the Marama. Final log update will be made once we are on the Marama. Some interesting history did happen. This is like a two-week de-expedition. And they hope to work 45 or so days. And the weather, I guess, was just too much. I wasn't there. I don't know. But man, oh man, the money that was invested. Oh gosh. Just makes you feel bad, right? They did make a very historic queue on the 11th on 15 meters. Take a look at that. Morse code at 10:30 GMT, 3Y0J, number 3 DXCC, with number 2, other way around, pardon me, at 3Y0J, number 2 on DXCC. Food number 3, Crozet Island, 2022 there, with FT8 Whiskey. Now, you know, what's interesting about this is that there's a huge difference between these two locations on Earth. First of all, theory, FT8 Whiskey on Crozet, there's permanent housing. There's housing on that island. So he has the benefit of having electricity and having heat, right? And having the ability to work in better conditions than throwing a tent or a set of tents actually up onto an ice shelf island with a little bit of rock that they can put some antennas up and the tents up and the heaters and all the stuff they needed to do and try and make something work from probably the most remote location, if not one of them, on planet Earth and make that work. I don't know what they faced. I'm sure it was a lot of storms and they finally just had enough after 2 weeks. So how do you feel about it? Let's talk about it in the comment section and we'll make it part of today's show. Again, news broke that 3Y0J is over after about just 2 weeks of being on the air. I want to show you something real quick. For new amateurs, this might be helpful to you. A way you can find out if you've got like a hex beam or some sort of a directional, what direction to point your antenna to work a various place on Earth, like a DXPedition, like for example, Crozet shown on the screen here. You can see by just putting in a cue from your location where you live, right? And then just put it in and then go and edit it. You're going to go to double click on it. And then you'll find, of course, you see down below where distance is, right? Then it shows the degrees from true north from where you're at to beam straight to where that station is. It's a really good indicator. Remember, the first side, you want the left side. That's 65 degrees for me to beam towards Crozet Island. It kind of sounds weird that way, but because the QSL is 2 FT8 Whiskey, that's why the degrees is there on that end. So I would have to point my antenna 65 degrees to work it. For 3Y0J, totally different. It was at 96 degrees versus 276 from Bouvet if they were to work it that way. Buddy Hex just spun around and we made the change to try and work the Crozet Island expedition. We'll see how that goes. Also, I do want to take a moment. This is important. I want to thank Rodney. Rodney, Pop Alpha 9 Romeo Whiskey. He sat with me for probably 2 hours sourcing out what the heck was wrong with my laptop, why it wasn't able to work FT8. It was the weirdest doggone thing. We finally got the doggone thing working. No kidding. Jeez. And you know what the problem was? Problem was I had two of the WSJT X suites. I had two different ones going. I'm not going, but on the screen. And I didn't realize that there was two. So yeah, we got everything working and now it came just in time so that we couldn't get 3Y0J. Let me show you real quick. And it was close. You know, I think it was close to at least having a chance to work it. You know, it wasn't like Larry was really right at the edge. He had the call, and he just was waiting for the RR to come over. No, but we could definitely hear them and had a chance to hear some of their, in fact, it was their last transmissions on the 17-meter band today, trying to work a little bit more FT8 before they shut it down on Bouvet Island. Let me know what your thoughts are about Bouvet closing down early, and we'll talk about that today on Ham Radio Live, all right? That's today's topic question. Let me see who we got to talk. By the way, I want to welcome everybody here, especially the Smoking Ape. It's always a pleasure to see you, mate. It really is. Thank you for coming. It's always my pleasure to say hello to you, and thank you for coming. I mean that sincerely. You're a dear person to me. Thank you. Also, Sam Weaver from the beautiful state of Alabama has joined us. Sweet home, got that one. Just that there's all, everything's all messed up here. All my stuff is not in the right place. It's just not here.
That's the last straw.
Yeah.
Now I use my secret weapon.
Pretty much. Yeah, that's where we're at. So, oh, wait a minute. There we go. Hey, we found it. There's like 900,000 of these things. I'm not sure. Hey, G-Mac G, welcome back. Good to see you all the way from England. Gordon, welcome. Mike 3, Golf Quebec Tango. It's nice to see you again. My name's Larry. It's good to have you here tonight. Sorry about that. And William in Holy Toledo, Ohio. Bless his heart. Ham Radio Life at work. Work just got better. Yeah, thank you. That's very kind of you to say. So how are you feeling about this closing down so quickly? Robert Varner. Good to see you, and just got back from the dentist. I get to go on Thursday. I'm really excited for that.
And I didn't like it one bit.
Yeah, I'm going to be like Grandpa Simpson, I think. Be like that. We'll see how things go. Phil Durall, welcome as well as Andy and all the gang who usually come, Jason and everybody who's here. Thank you guys for being here. It's always a pleasure to see all of you from around the world. Lionel and Aaron and Andy and all the Andes and Jonathan and all y'all being here. It's good to see you guys. Thank you for coming. Country Strong, everybody else too. Aaron from Canada says, first one, I'm so disappointed with 3Y0J. You know, the one thing I didn't see, and I told Rodney this, I didn't ever hear about them doing like a practice run, right? Because this is a lot of money, and you're going in the middle of nowhere to make calls from someplace that's very remote, right? I never thought, you know, I wasn't there. I don't know what happened. I didn't face what they've had to face, and there's nobody in the entire world who could be more disappointed than them. Absolutely no one. You got to think of how they feel. You know, they're coming back on the ship after only about 2 weeks out there. And I mean, they know everyone's disappointed. They know it was a bad, you know, zoo to get a hold of them, and people are causing a lot of DQRM. There's a lot of mess working. And it just, you know, they just can't come back as their heads held high. And that's too bad. It is disappointing. It really is. Andy says they run out of petrol and have a big storm coming in the weekend. Yeah, that's part of it. But no, the petrol part was not part of it. They planned they were going to continue operating until the petrol ran out on the island, and then they were going to bring everything back. That was the idea. But they didn't have a lot of their antennas, the amplifiers. That stuff was stayed on the Marama. So it just seemed like it's one thing after another for that poor group of people. And like I say, who knows what's, you know, who knows the whole story? We're going to hear about it soon for sure. Tom in Bahrain, good to see you. Good evening. Very late your way, sir. What is it, about 2 or 1:38? No, it's about like 1 or 2:09 a.m. My goodness.
Get down on your knees and tell me you love me.
I know you love me, Tom. You're a good man. So I have a feeling this would happen. Just hoping everyone else make the trip home safe and sound. Indeed, yeah. Like I say, we're not there, right? We don't know what happened other than this was a rough trip for those guys. Phil Durall, smart call, life over all else. And that right there with Tom's, I think, honestly, is probably the comment of the show. It really is. You know, we can think about our disappointment with not making a QSO, and that's all it is. That's why I always think about people who have to give their call sign multiple times, right, to try and make a call to somebody, and they've got to get it because, man, it's worth more than anything in the world to them. So they're going to call 9,000 times in 60 seconds their call sign because they've got to get it over somebody else. And it's like, it's just a call. It's just a QSO. Sure, we'd love to all have it, but it's not the end of the world if we don't. This is Ham Radio. We're here to have a good time. Phil, thank you. That's a really nice comment. Thank you. And Tom, too. Yep, same thing. Aaron, they didn't get on the air until the 6th. Yeah, like I say, about 2 weeks. So what was it? I guess it's less than 2 weeks, right? 8 days? 9 days? Nobody's got to feel worse than those guys do. Nobody. I can't imagine, really. That's got to be a tough, tough thing. What do you think about it? What do you think about the early end of 3Y0J? And it does make it more difficult with Crozet being extended, right? Because, you know, theory, FT8 Whiskey, and Crozet got the extension for another 4 weeks, but he can only transmit for 3. That gets him into about March 3rd. So March 3rd, that the expedition is going to go QRT there. So, you know, but he has housing. There's shelter. Things are there that aren't on Bouvet. And I just, wow, they got to be so disappointed. Yeah. Aaron from Canada also says, I thought they were supposed to be there for the whole month. Doesn't sound like they planned very well. And I think a lot of people probably will be thinking and asking those questions in the next coming weeks for sure. Can you imagine? And I was thinking about this before I went live. Can you imagine being one of those people from 3Y0J and having to take interviews? I wouldn't want to do that. I wouldn't. My gosh, I mean, I'm one of the 13 people that didn't make it very long on the place we worked so hard to get to and worked so hard raising money to be able to do. Man, I just, oof. I think it's awful. It's a darn thing. Yeah. Eamon is having problems with a doggone cap lock.
You're way off. I say you're way off this time, son.
Every time I do a show here and I'm trying to get stuff done, I always touch the stupid cap lock too. I get it. Yep. Andy New, it's late for you. Mike 7 Charlie, you're in November from United Kingdom. Welcome, Andy. Good to see you. Talking about the 3Y0J, the expedition just kind of being done now. It's all over. So nothing to look forward to from Bouvet anymore until the next expedition comes together. But the knowledge from this crew is going to help the next one. Because you know there's going to be another crew that's going to try it because they want things to be successful. They really do. Everyone wants to be successful, no matter what they do in life. And so, like I said, I wouldn't want to be one of these guys having to do an interview when you get back on, you know, the mainland. Country strong and free. So, guys, I think I've decided to put my general on the back burner. Don't you dare do that. No. Look, man, the solar cycle is going up, and it's going up a lot faster than people even thought. There's no one out there that had picked this solar cycle for one group in Colorado that thought this would be a really huge solar cycle. Now's the time to get that license upgrade because, man, the calls you make now on 40 and 80 and especially 80, man, you can make some amazing calls. And 10 is going to be open well into the evening in the summertime. It's a great time, country. Get that license upgrade. It's what you're well worth it. You're worth it. You really are. Ed, Kilo 3, Charlie Uniform, first timer, want to say welcome to you. My name's Larry. Welcome to the show, Ed. It's nice to have you. Again, talking about how you feel about the end of the 3Y0J expedition today. Cliff Bolts, Whiskey Delta 4, Oscar Bravo Papa from Virginia. Hi, Cliff. Good to see you. I got to stop this bouncing ball. This MP3 thing is like bouncing everywhere. Andy from the UK, Bouvet was never a possibility for me, but I admire their efforts. Yeah, and most of their calls, the majority were in Europe. Absolutely. They were close to 50%, a little over that, I believe, the last metric. In fact, let me get you the last metric on it, because I believe that most of their calls, at least spots, were Europe. And then the North American continent made like about 30% or so, right? And there's where they stayed for the most part. FT8 whiskeys, basically the same exact stats. They're very, very close to each other. Jonathan in the UK, I'm rather glad I didn't put any money behind the venture. I feel sorry for the big money sponsors. I asked my wife this today. It's interesting you bring that up, okay? If you were a company who had donated money to this expedition, right? It's close to $750,000. Would you expect money back? I told my wife, I said, you know, if I had, you know, been told it'd be like 40 days and they were going to be there, yeah, I probably would. You know, I probably would. And so, I mean, like I say, I don't know everything that they had to face, but I'm sure glad I'm not one of them because that's got to be really a tough thing for them. But I'm sure a relief as well to be off the island. No question about that. Steve, welcome. That's a first timer. It's good to have you. My name's Larry. Welcome to Ham Radio Live. Yeah. Good to see you, Steve. He says, I'm sympathetic to a point. They were highly sponsored and contributed. Amen. You're right. Yes. With 12 ops, I didn't feel they made a real effort to be QRO. Exactly. Yep. The DQRM won because they couldn't control their TX frequency. Man, is there a ton of wisdom right there. Steve, you nailed it. Exactly. From moment one, there was DQRM all over it. And it was bad. It was really bad. And people were complaining. They were experienced DXPedition people were saying, look, this is what's worked for us when we did our DXPeditions, possibly try this, right? And it seemed like things just never changed. It was like they kept doing the same thing. And it's too bad because, you know, honestly, I think they probably could have had more luck had they done something like it. Steve, thank you. That's a really good comment right there. He's right. And they were highly, highly sponsored. Eamon Azar from the state of Minnesota. By the way, he's in Indiana. He's got a nice special event station. He's got the JY1 Memorial Special Event Station through the end of the month. Try and work him. He's really good, experienced amateur, and he's been on the air for a long, long time. Eamon's call sign, November 9, Sierra Echo Sierra, 3Y0J. I really gave up on them the first day. The weather is not the main reason they shut down 3Y0J. I think multiple of reasons. One of them is the DQRM. So what does that mean for our future, right? Does that mean that we're done with the expeditions? Because, you know, you got your sponsors. Are we done with big D expeditions now? Because people are just going to act like morons and cause trouble so people can't make calls. Think about that. That's what happened. The guy that's in, he's in Finland. I can't remember. Oscar Mike to MET. I know that part. MET YouTube channel. Good guy. Really smart. Does lots of great stuff. And all he did was just put his receiver on the radio, on YouTube, and let people hear it for an hour or so. He didn't need to say a single word because the radio spoke for itself. It's exactly what was going on with those guys. So, yeah, a lot of DQRM. And Eamon, that's an interesting comment. Thank you. Yep. I just realized I didn't bring my bottle of water with me today. So my voice gets a little bit scratchy or whatever. Just give me a little bit of a latitude on that. All right, Eamon, thank you for your comment. It's a nice comment. It really is. I appreciate it. Eamon also said the other is a financial QSL system. Lots of hams didn't like that path. Another thing I've seen myself is the times versus propagation for certain areas. Okay, very good. He says when they called CQDX calling North America only in the wrong time that propagation permits. Europe was receiving them 599. North America was hardly hearing them. It was a mess, and he's very disappointed. You know, I did a show about this, and I'm pleased. Oh, my gosh, if you know me very well at all, if it's your first time here, welcome. I mean that. I try and be very personal and very kind to people and look at kind of the bright side of things. But can you imagine if you aren't prepared for that? Because I tried to prepare all of you guys by saying, okay, Their time zone is plus one. Here is where the meter bands are right now. And what really stinks is the 10-meter band is sliding south right now. Within a few days, that 10-meter band was at least going to be open for part of the day where 3Y0J is. And it's going to be open for FT8 Whiskey Whiskey. Watch this. It's coming. Right now, I would say today is Monday. By Wednesday, they're going to start seeing some, you'll start hearing some 10-meter spots with FT8 Whiskey Whiskey. Because the 10-meter band sliding south again. And it's too bad they just couldn't stick it out just a little bit longer because it would have made a huge difference for them. That's a good comment. Eamon, thank you. Knowing where you're working and how you're working is number one to any kind of de-expedition. Absolutely. It's like in radio. You know your audience. You have to know your audience, and you have to be able to communicate to them to get good ratings. That's how it used to work. Now it's just homogenized. That's a lot different story. Anyway, Eamon, thank you very, very much. Steve says, interviews at Hamventions will... Yeah, it will. Absolutely. I mean, like I say, could you imagine being one of these guys? And I'm just... Please bear with me. I'm going to put some stats on the screen for you. Could you imagine being one of these guys and have to take interviews now? Well, I was there for about 10 days, tried to make calls work, and just didn't work out. And the weather started getting bad, and we thought, nope, they're done. We're just going to pack it in. Whew. Weren't you prepared for bad weather? Don't you realize you're in a subarctic island all alone and the weather is usually bad and the seas are very high in that area of the world? There's a lot of people going to be asking lots of questions. Steve, thank you. Nice comment. Like it. I like it a lot. Hey, Charlie's here. Hi, Charlie. November Juliet 7 Victor. He says, I've been MIA but not forgotten. I hope, of course, you're not forgotten. Charlie, it's nice to see you. Great YouTube channel right there, too. You'll learn a lot from him. And he's one of the kindest people I know, too. Charlie, like the ape, welcome. Nice YouTube person there. Really is. Anders joins us. Hi, Anders. Good night. So late here. Just have to meet her and say hi. Did you get the F-take going, Larry? I sure as heck did. Thank you. Yes. Just in time for 3Y0J to go off. No kidding. I was like, man, I got him. Oh, it's going to work. We're going to make the call. We're going to make the call. They're gone. And it's like, you can see it. Like 17 meters was like going. It was rolling. Lots of activity. And then bang. No kidding. It was like it happened all at one time. Done. It was over. It's tough. It really is. So yeah, it's going to be an issue. Anders, thank you for joining us all the way from Norway. Always a pleasure. Thank you, buddy. Anders is a good dude. Good dude. CC, welcome. Call sign Whiskey Oscar 8, USA. Good to see you. I love the call sign. Thanks for being there, Larry. Always a great show. CC, thank you. It's nice to have you today. Thanks for being here. Tommy is here. Hi, bud, from Sweden. Sierra Alpha 3, Alpha Tango, Foxtrot. It's good to have you here. Thank you, Tommy, for joining the show. Nice to see you again. I wondered, and I said this to, and here we go. Good, probably Paul. This is good. He said, lots of speculation. Certainly would be. Think about that. There's going to be a lot of people saying this, that, and the other thing. But what really happened? They'll tell us, and you know, we'll know the truth. Just a second. Let me get you something on screen. So FJH is kind of playing here. I'm not doing anything with it right now. But I wanted to show you something real quick. This is gives you an idea, at least, because at least the channel tries to be helpful in a way to people that you can be successful in amateur radio. And part of this here is to show you just some statistics that I hope will be helpful. Okay, first of all, we're going to take a look at the first one. This is for, this is for FJ8 Whiskey. Okay, so this is for Crozet, all right? Currently, this is the DX spots by continent. Take a look. The North American continent, about 30%. Europe, about 57%. And this is very similar to what was worked by 3Y0J. We'll put them up in a second. So remember, 29 and change for North America, right? So here is 3Y0J. See that? Same thing. It's the same amount of spots, just about the same, Europe, North America. And the people that were on 3Y0J were saying they were working North America a lot. And they said one night they worked the West Coast. I guess, possible. Yeah. FT8, you can do that maybe. But the DQRM was the problem. It just was insane to try and work them. So, yeah. I agree. Paul, it is. It's a lot of speculation. See what happens. Yeah, and there you go, Paul. There we go. Paul, Oscar Mike Zero ET. Thank you, Tom. A little over the horizon radio there. Thank you. It's true. Yeah. And Steve got right, too. Yeah. I love his channel. I always learn something. It's kind of cool. Aaron, I worry that this will ruin the ability of others to get sponsorship. Time will tell. It'll be interesting. We heard so much about sponsorship with 3Y0J, didn't we? Right? We heard a lot of people were behind it. A lot of money went behind it. But can you name five sponsors for FT8 Whiskey? Can you do that? I can't. I can't do that. But the guy is cranking out cues by himself. And okay, I get it. He's in a house, right? He's got like structure around him. But still, look what he's doing. And he got an extension. He's still working. That guy's been working since Christmas Day. FT8 Whiskey, and he's going to go through March the 6th. Well, Aaron says, I stayed up late a few times. They were never on a band that worked up to Northern USA or Canada. That was me too. Yep, that was me too. Same thing. Tom says, in Middle East, he says, I heard them on Friday on 15 meters, but it was obvious, no chance. It was crazy. If you looked at many DX spotting networks with 3Y0J, you saw the words zoo, usually followed by people in the comment section. Because it was a zoo. It was crazy. All you do is listen on YouTube. A few people who had a chance to listen to them, mainly in Europe or in the Middle East, part of Africa, East Coast of North America was good too. But there was so much noise and people were whistling and playing sound effects. And it was like 80 meters was on fire.
Yeah.
Jeez. That's what it was like. It was just crazy. Yeah. Andy says they were well trained and had a lot on. I'm sure they were. I'm sure they were well trained. I'm sure that they had a lot of but man, less than 2 weeks or so? I don't know, man. I mean, I'm not them, and I wouldn't want to be them. I feel bad for them. I truly do, because they're going to be having to answer for what happened, and that's going to be hard. I always said, if there's one thing, and by Andrews, get some rest. Thank you for joining us, buddy. I always said, you know, if one person went down And this is true for any expedition, right? You have a crew of guys, they go somewhere, guys and gals, right? And you get the food, the fuel, all the stuff you need to go. And then someone has an accident, gets hurt. What happens? Does the expedition end at that point? I mean, that might have happened to this. You never know. But at the same time, it seemed like storm after storm after storm, but they're also in a part in the Southern Ocean where there are a lot of storms. That should have been like, okay. I kind of thought, I wonder why they wouldn't maybe go up to Svalbard, right? Because Svalbard is Norwegian. Be a great place to just go, land, get a Zodiac, get land stuff on the island, try and put tents up, and get practical experience for it. That's kind of what I wondered about that. But yeah, who knows? It will be interesting to see what happens then. That Charlie in Red Summit, I started activating at 18.092 for POTA this Saturday. Clear frequency. After a while, yep, the chasing station started bleeding over. I was just trying to stay out of their way all week, LOL. You know what? For a lot of us, we're glad it's over. Because it was. They were not on typical FT8 frequencies. And that's true even to today, because they were at 18.108. That's where they were at on 17. And they seem to go to a lot of those places too. Jason, poor 3Y0J had to fight severe weather, pirates, and terrible QRM. And so has Theory, FT8 Whiskey Whiskey. He's had to fight pirates too, a lot of them. And the guy's still doing it by himself, which I think is phenomenal. It's a neat thing. But I like the question, the comment about other people sponsoring down the road. I'm sure that'll be still happening. I'm sure people will do it. But there's going to be an eye to it. Like, okay, if you don't fulfill this much time, then this is what we get back money-wise, right? Because otherwise you're out the money and there wasn't much time spent. I feel bad for that. I really do feel bad for them. DiBiase, welcome. Kilo Charlie 1, Papa Sierra Kilo. It's good to see you. Oh, my friend, always a pleasure. Steve, welcome. Golf 1 X-Ray Oscar Whiskey. First timer, welcome. My name's Larry. Welcome to Ham Radio Live. It's nice to see you. He says, obviously, the second most wanted is going to be hard, real hard. Too many armchair critics that wouldn't even make the boat trip, never mind the days in the tent with the snow and minus 15 Celsius outside. There's a great comment right there, too. Absolutely.
Get down on your knees and tell me you love me.
Right, yeah. Good comment, Steve. Like I said at the beginning, we weren't there. We don't know what happened or the stories that were behind it. But I think when you raise $750,000 to nearly close, it was close. It's like $680,000 or something like that. I don't know. It's close. But you would be in shape. You'd be good to go. You'd know how to fight certain things and what to do if this happened or that happened. Something bad must have happened. I mean, something had to happen or a series of events happened. And we'll find out about that. And I feel bad for them. I hope for safe travel, that they get off the island safely, because it is a far different place than Crozet. Crozet has housing. Bouvet is an ice shelf with a little bit of rock on the southern face, and they have some areas where they can kind of, you know, get up top and try and work. Wasn't there, but man, I feel bad for the guys. Like I say, hard to do interviews after that for sure. Steve, thank you. It's good to meet you and a good comment too. Nice. Something we all need to keep in mind. Imagine living in a place in the summer when it's minus 15 Celsius out there. No kidding. Steve says, he says, based on 15,000 QSOs, I did the math, 750,000 divided by 15,000 equals $50 per QSO. Well, that, sir, is truly a lot of change. Yes. Wow. Yeah, well, they made a lot. You know, they did good, though, guys. I mean, for how long they were there and who knows what they had to face. I know that they couldn't bring the amplifiers over because the seas were so rough in the Zodiac. They were afraid of capsizing. They were worried about the amplifiers and stuff. But I wasn't there. I don't know. I can't physically do something like this. I can't do a de-expedition. I couldn't. I feel bad for them. I do. I feel terrible because I would hate to have to answer for stuff for a long time. Who knows? Maybe it's tough. Raleigh, here's a guy that's done a lot of de-expeditions and a dear friend of mine. Raleigh, it's really nice to have you. Welcome. Now, you want to see, and I invite you to do this, please. Mark down his call sign, ZL1BQD. He has done so many de-expeditions. Raleigh has experience. Here's what he said. Not a lot has changed since the 80s when we did the very rare ones at the time of ZL9, ZL8, and. Raleigh has done it. Been there, done that. He's really, please go to his YouTube channel. Not now, don't leave yet, but seriously, go see some of his excursions to these places because he has film of it. It's phenomenal. Raleigh, it's an honor to have you on this day. Thank you for coming. Seriously. I wonder, did they ever reach out to you? Or did you ever reach out to them? I know you have such great experience for DXPedition work about maybe ways to fight the DQRM. What would you have done differently? Yeah, I just wonder from your perspective, because it was really, really bad. Raleigh continues, he says, we didn't have shore stations, internet spotters, et cetera, in the days, but the deliberate QRM was still there back in the day. Yep, but you just persevered and got through it. It just was part of the process. Raleigh, it's really good to see you. Raleigh, you're a good friend. God bless you, man. I mean that. Thank you for being here today. Truly mean that. He said, let's see, we go on. He says, oh no, FT8. Then, of course, was only CW, sideband, and a little radio teletype. Man, how many have you done, Raleigh? You've done Timor-Leste. I know that. You've done New Guinea. I know that. I'm trying to think of some other places. I'm looking at the map here of just some places where I'm sure you have worked. Have you worked Kiribati? I think you worked Kiribati or somewhere close to Kiribati. I think so. But Raleigh has worked at a lot of DXPeditions. Phenomenal operator, really is, and knows it very, very well. Yeah. He agrees, is a reason why it's essential, number one on the charts. And what he's doing, he's agreeing with Steve's comment. And Steve's really, really smart comment here. Obviously, the second most wanted is going to be hard, real hard. And I like the comment of armchair critics. And I suppose maybe I'm being one right now. And I don't mean to be. I came here because I wanted to at least talk about it with you guys because it just happened not more than a few hours ago. And it's nice to get comments from all of you around the world about how you feel about it, right? We weren't there, and we didn't share their experiences. Thank goodness we weren't there. I wouldn't want to be in their shoes right now. That'd be terrible. Mm. Tom says, was there the expedition years ago, 3Y0Z? I think there was. Yes, there was one in the 90s, I thought. I read about prior one that was there. Yeah. Andy from the UK, one wonders what the sponsors thought they were going to get out of it. Absolutely. Absolutely. Especially if you're an antenna manufacturer, right? If you're an antenna manufacturer and you're at DXCC2 and it handles the wind and it handles the storms and it handles all the stuff that, you know, throws at it, of course you would do good. Absolutely. Andy, nice comment. That's a very good comment. And, you know, the sponsors are there for a reason. DX Engineering was involved pretty heavy. ICOM was involved. They were using K3. So I think Elecraft was involved as well. So, Andy, thank you. Nice comment. Sure. Yep. By the way, look at this. We got Kilo Papa 4, Oscar Tango Alpha. Saludos de Sueto, Puerto Rico. Welcome, sir. Good to see you. All the way from Puerto Rico. Thank you for coming today. It's nice to have you today. It really is. Yeah. And there's a special event, JY1, now on 17 meters, QRV. Thank you for that. Appreciate it. Steve from the UK says, at the end of the day, I'm certain that they didn't go to 3Y to fail. Absolutely not. No. And remember, if you go back in the history of this DXPedition, it was kind of fraught with problems from the beginning. They were planning to be there in the beginning to early middle January, right in that time slot, right? Then they had a hard time getting, they got down there. It was going to be the 25th of January. Then it was later, the 26th. And then it got later and later. It went into February. But they kept fighting through it. And I give them a lot of credit for that because they kept on having challenges, but they found a way to still try. And they still had people that were on the air in terrible conditions, trying to make as many calls as they could out of the decency of their heart, because they knew they were there for that purpose. Totally agree. Steve, thank you. It's a nice comment. It really is. It is. We weren't there. And there we go. Raleigh, this is how much experience he has. 35 DXPeditions to 28 different countries. Raleigh, thank you. Seriously, thank you. So he knows a lot about QRM. He's been one of the guys that's been on the DXPedition sites. Absolutely. Raleigh, thank you. This guy, rarefied air. He's very, very special. So thank you for being here. I want to welcome my brother, Bob. Starts radiation treatment tomorrow. Bob, we'll get through this together. And I'm grateful you're here. Thank you, Bob. It's nice to see you. Robert Varner says, I do the expeditions from my backyard. There you go. Absolutely. There you go. What do you think about, real quick, final comments? Didn't mean to drop that off the screen. You know, my thoughts originally was I was just going to kind of play a little bit in the backyard, see if I could maybe get, you know, maybe a DX call or two on the radio. And I'll be honest, I have the hex beam up higher than I've ever had it. Mine's a portable hex beam, so it's not built to, you know, it's not on a tower. So I wish I could. My neighbors would kill me, and I'd have a problem with that. But it's on a nice, you know, guide antenna, and it's up quite high for its design, because I wanted 3Y0J. That was my thing. I wanted that. And then I wanted to try and get through, you know, FT8 whiskey. But at the end of the day, you're not them. You're not going through what they have to go through. So I give them a lot of credit for having the courage to go to that place too, because they knew it wouldn't be easy, yet they still came. And I think of how many times they had to sit there and pound those tent pegs in, you know, because they had to have shelter. Oh, and they had to, every time, I don't know, many people might not know this, they would have to leave the Marama, go on to the Zodiac in survival suits, because the water is so cold, the seas are so choppy, and they had to be, you know, they had to be in a survival suit for the safety of their lives. Man, and right now, can you imagine how they must feel getting all that stuff off the island? It's not daylight there yet. Wait a minute. Nope, not yet, because they're in the southern Atlantic. But they're doing the best they can to get off the island before the storm hits. I know there's a storm coming, but at the same time, they're trying to remove everything and get everything back on board the Marama. And I give them a lot of credit for that. Tom, good night. Thank you for being here, and thank you for coming so late. Tom, it's nice to see you as always. Good night, and have a good rest. Andy New, comment, finally, and we're going to close the show here. One wouldn't volunteer for such a rough journey to fail, that's for sure. Absolutely, yeah. What I would hope is that the amateur radio community can look at themselves in the mirror and ask, well, why didn't I volunteer? Or why didn't I get involved? You know, if they're going to be really angry, critical, because there's a lot of people mad about the DQRM, and they should be. That should never be allowed. Never, ever on amateur radio. We should never, ever feel that's okay to have people do what they've done. No question. But man, those guys are pretty brave to put up what they did. Seriously, think about what they had to do. They were closer to the Antarctic continent than they were to any other continent in the world. And they were alone. You know, they had a group of people by themselves off a sailboat going from a Zodiac over to this ice shelf island, you know, steering around penguins to go and get antennas and tents up and petrol on the island and all the other stuff, the food and everything they needed. Give them a lot of credit for what they did. I really do. Steve, we'll make this final comment here. I wonder if hams will want to return radios, antennas purchased for refunds with purchases based on working 3Y. Wow. Now that's interesting. That really is. Look at this comment. I wonder if hams want to return radio/antennas purchased for refunds with purchases based on working 3Y0J. That's a very interesting comment. That's very deep, really is. Because if you based everything on making that call, because you wanted 2 and 3 on your wall, right? You wanted to get the QSL card, get the spot ready for it, and you were cool with doing it, right? And then it wasn't even 2 weeks. And I feel bad for him. I really do. That had to be such a tough thing because it was a team decision. It really was. And Aaron didn't go because they didn't have the spare $60,000 to go. Whew. And in the budget, each person was reimbursed $20,000 each. True. Each one of them, 20 grand. So yeah, I feel terrible. It's gotta be really hard for them. Jonathan, Mike Zero, Juliet Sierra X-ray, final comment of the show. I thought that the best way to get items on the island was using a helicopter. Would have ramped up the cost, but would have got the amps on. Absolutely. You know what? That's a very neat comment. Wow. And, you know, you think about that, right? If you got so much money to be able to do this, maybe a ship with a helicopter. I don't know. It's got to cost a lot of money. But yeah, that makes perfect sense. Everything is just flown right in and you get flown off the island. But boy, I don't know what that would cost. That'd be That would be a lot of dough. Yeah, indeed, Jonathan. Yeah. And Steve, and this is true. Think about it. This is a possibility. There may unfortunately be legal ramifications from sponsors. If you are a big company and you are giving a lot of money to a group of people, you're expecting something. Your expectations are high, right? No. You know, I think they tried. They did the Facebook thing. They posted their frequencies every day, and then they would post them multi times a day if they were changing, right? To try and fight the DQRM. They did their best to keep their news in front of people so they knew what was going on from a place that you have no internet from. They, who knows how uncomfortable they were in that awful climate with the wind blowing as hard as it was and the ship rocking like crazy. You've seen the videos. If you haven't, the Marama, which is a big sailboat, is just rolling in the seas and the seas are just pounding. And that's normal for that area of the world, right? But you've got to get stuff up the hill on the island and back down to the ship. And it does make you wonder if there's going to be maybe something from people saying, wait a minute, you promised at least a month or at least whatever the contract says. Steve, good comment. That's a good comment. Absolutely. Yeah. And Steve, this is nice. This is a good comment. Look at this. You mean like Super Bowl fans go back to Best Buy or Monday to return their brand new 1,000-inch TV set? Well, the game's over now. Sure was good. Loved it all the way to the end. See you later, everybody. There's my cash. Thank you. People do stuff like that. They do. Lionel, and that's true. That's too sad. It's really too bad. Kilo Juliet 7, Oscar Foxtrot Hotel. That's just like people who buy a big screen just for the Super Bowl and then take it back to the after the game. That's just crumbly and ridiculous. I agree with you. It is, absolutely. But we're not talking about a $3,000 television. We're talking about almost $700,000, you know? Wow. It's tough. And the guys all, you know, they were a team. They voted together if they were going to stop or they were going to continue. They did. They did that. We know that for sure because they've stated that. I just can't imagine how difficult it would be to do an interview with one of them after this, because this experience has changed their life forever and not in a great way. My wife asked me, and I'll close with this. If I was going to do a DXPedition, I would want to do it in a place that's warm, not hot, not terribly hot, but someplace that's at least warm. I wouldn't want to go to a subantarctic island ever. So I admire their courage for having the guts to go on a sailboat from the Falkland Islands all the way over to Bouvet and you know, risk who knows how much to be able to put a ham radio DXPedition on for a group of people around the world trying to make that call. God bless them. Safe travels. I hope they get back home safely and that this becomes something that they look back at as experience that makes them better people, even though they didn't get their goal of 200,000 Qs and weren't there for 40 plus days. They still get the experience that we don't get. And God bless them. Safe travels. All right, guys, that's it for the show. Thanks for being here. Sorry about the tough news for 3Y0J, but please support Theory over on Crozet Island. You can still make the call with him all the way until March the 3rd. He's got the extension to work. They did make the call between the two of them, which is historic. That's a kind of a cool thing. Crozet Island being on the air here with their special event. That's the FT8 Whiskey special event. Goes on until March the 3rd. Okay. Till we see each other again, wherever you may be, thank you for being good people. Thanks for coming to the show today and talking about a tough day in amateur radio, where unfortunately DXCC number 2 is now unobtainable yet again. Hopefully in the future, we'll come back with another DXPedition. Till we see each other again, thank you for being here, guys. I appreciate you coming. I never ask for subscriptions. I just thank you for being here. Goodbye, everybody.